This is the 20th in a series called Black Adventist Women You Should Know, highlighting 28 extraordinary Black Adventist women for Black History Month. At blacksdhistory.org, everything is free, but we do ask you to donate if you can on the PayPal link in the video description below. Shirley Verrett was born in New Orleans in 1931 to devout Seventh-day Adventist parents. Instead of migrating north, like most Blacks who moved from the South in the 1930s, the Verretts relocated west to California when Shirley was 5, and there she attended Adventist schools all the way to Oakwood. From her youth, Verrett was considered a musical phenom, possessing a rich and powerful singing voice. In her 20s, she studied at Juilliard and won the Metropolitan Opera National Council audition. She made her operatic debut in 1957, but debuted at Manhattan's Met in 1968 as Carmen. Throughout her career, she performed as a mezzo and soprano. From the start, Verrett's career was marked by obstacles from racism and personal health. For instance, in 1959, she was slated as the solo lead for the Houston Symphony Orchestra, but the offer was withdrawn because she was Black. Race would continue to hinder her progress as a performer, both overtly and covertly. For as many times as she was hindered, though, she broke through, as when she became the first Black person to perform with the Bolshoi Opera in Moscow, Russia. Health-wise, in the peak of her career, Verrett suffered from allergies, Candida albicans, which is a yeast infection, and mold spores that clogged her bronchial tubes. Maddeningly, she never knew when these problems would flare up, and they often did during performances. For one stretch, she had to withdraw from performing for several months. Despite this, according to the New York Times, Verrett never quite reached mythic status in the world of opera, but she came close and was, quote, the premier mezzo-soprano of her generation. She headlined at all the major opera houses in the U.S. and Europe and received the highest accolades from musical critics of the New York Times, Musical America, The Washington Post, The New Yorker, and other publications. In 1975, she sang the soprano role of Lady Macbeth in a landmark production of Verdi's Macbeth at La Scala in Milan, and Milanese critics and impassioned Italian opera fans called her La Nera Callas, or the Black Callas, and flocked to her performances. In 1976, Verrett sang Adagisa in Bellini's Norma at the Metropolitan Opera as a mezzo-soprano, and then the daunting soprano title role on tour with the Met. In the Met's 1978-79 season, Verrett sang Tosca to Luciano Pavarotti's Cavaradossi in a production of Puccini's Tosca that was broadcast live on public television. Indeed, Verrett would perform at the Met 126 times and was frequently on TV shows, famously the Ed Sullivan Show in 1964. In the 1980s, Verrett was so beloved by musical audiences in Paris that she moved there for 3 years, and in 1984, the French government recognized her artistic achievements with the Commendeur des Artes et des Lettres. You can tell my French is not too good. Verrett also lent her considerable voice to the civil rights movement, performing at programs and raising money for activist organizations by putting on concerts. She refused to perform to segregated audiences, and her stance not infrequently led to the desegregation of a venue, however temporarily. She was among the first to protest the apartheid regime of South Africa by refusing to perform in their country. Throughout her career, Verrett frequently performed gratis in Adventist venues, including Andrews Walla Walla and Oakwood Universities, and at numerous churches. In 1994, at age 63, Verrett made her Broadway debut in the Tony Award-winning production of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Carousel at Lincoln Center, culminating with You'll Never Walk Alone. After retiring from opera, Verrett accepted a professorship at the University of Michigan and was endowed as a James Earl Jones Distinguished Professor of Voice. After she died in 2011, the University of Michigan established an ongoing annual Shirley Verrett Award that recognizes, quote, a faculty member whose performance, scholarship, or service supports the success of female students or faculty in the arts who come from diverse cultural and racial backgrounds. Throughout her life, Verrett would receive countless accolades and awards. Shirley Verrett passed to her rest at age 79 in 2010.